Can a woman be a Sharia counselor? Yeah, that's the question from the sister side. Can a woman be a Sharia counselor?
Okay. Bismillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Anyway, this question is not related to the topic. It is not related to the topic. It doesn't mean that we mention the word Sharia, then any word related to Sharia is related to the topic. But can a woman be a Sharia counselor? What do you mean by a counselor? Yeah, someone whom other people can consult, of course. Yeah, why not? What is the point? What is the harm, I mean? Yeah, you can. And some sisters, they ask the question, can a woman be a mufti? Yeah, then we ask them, what do you mean by a mufti? Someone to give fatwas? Yeah, what do you mean by someone give fatwas? And I say to sisters, come on, if you are walking in the street and a lady, yeah, saw you with your hijab. And he said, sister, I want to ask you a question. Yes? Yes. How many rak'ah do we pray duhur? Yeah, the question is how many rak'ah we pray duhur? And the sister said, no, according to Islam, it is not allowed for a woman to be a mufti. Does that make sense? Does it make sense? It doesn't make sense. Because this is what? Huh? A question and answer. Dhuhr is to be prayed for rak'ah. It doesn't need a mufti or, yeah? Or, can you teach me Surah Fatiha? No. A woman cannot be a scholar. Teach her Surah Fatiha, come on. Yeah? So sometimes we just repeat some questions that we hear in the media without even analyzing what does the question mean. Yeah? And we differ on the questions and we fight on the questions while if we analyze them and if we do what Plato said, which is said by our scholars, that before getting into any debate, let us define what we are debating on. Yeah, go on.